Hi guys, this is Amanda, and today I'll be reading to you Frozen. And right there shows a picture of Elsa. And there is Kristoff. And there's Anna. And as you can perfectly see clearly in this picture, hair. Sort of like a blondie ginger. So yeah. And I don't know why she was born with blonde hair, but she was with ginger. I seriously don't know. Let's get from the actual book. Then it shows up a picture under the kingdom of Thunder was busy and happy back. Nestled among the mountains far north at night, the colourful northern lights displaying beautiful patterns. Kind King Queen ruled her. Ignore that noise, I just have cat walking over stuff. Shut open out. Good boy. They only looked Elsa and Anna when they were talking, but the other couple had a secret worry. Their eldest daughter, Elsa, had a magical friend. She could create snow and freeze things with her hands. Anna, the younger daughter, adored her big sister. The two were inseparable. One night, Anna convinced Elsa to sneak into the great hole in the cosmos to create a winter wonderland. But while the girls were playing, Elsa accidentally hit Anna with a blast of awesome magic. Little Anna fell to the ground, shivering. A streak of white hair, a streak of white, appeared in her hair. Frightened for her sister, Elsa called out for help. The worried King and Queen rushed their little sister. The child had mysterious healers. No. And it was that Anna knocked on the door. Don't ask me how she did not enter the door, because as you can see, she's just reaching up to the door latch. And it has a clock on it or something. As the girls grew, Anna kept trying to spend this time with her sister. Elsa said that she was busy. She was afraid that she might hurt her hundred. The game was getting more and more like strange with them when the two were teenagers. The King and Queen were tragically lost in a storm at sea. Sisters felt more sadder and more alone than ever. When your children with math, it's her turn to become queen. The gates can cause the world bent for one day only to celebrate the coronation. I was excited to meet so many people, especially a handsome young prince like Thomas. So I learned a lap book for today. And I'm going to quickly find something else to do. To watch Friday, and that means I'd have to go plan until my whole thing happens. So yeah, that's the end of it. I have to do it when my video card gets set. I haven't showed you yet. There's my little camera. Bring it into the light a little bit. Here it is. And it's easy to run, can you just go like... You just go... Like that, and then open it up. And see outside. By the way, I'm not trying to stop. See, it has all the batteries in it. Although, I just need the memory card. And then I can start using it and playing Roblox. Yay! You can all let deep breath, so I'm going to read my diamond gems. And if you don't know what this book is, it's about this family who don't want to move. And their last name is Diamond. And there's Dixie, the youngest. There's Martine, the oldest. There's Judy, the second oldest. And Rochelle, who is the second youngest. And this one, that is empty, is going to be a girl called Sundance. Yeah, the mum in this game, so pretends that Sundance is a boy because she really desperately wanted a boy. So let's get started with this. Chapter 1. I've got some eyes for you that always said to me, "We're moving." You've stared at her. She's flopping back in the hard chair. Slippered feet propped right up the kitchen table amongst the cornflakes. Tummy jutting over her skirt like a balloon. She didn't look capable of moving her muscles. She barely put her weight. Maybe she needed to put her hands on her. And she'd rise gently upwards and float out the open window. "But staring at my stomach, Dixie," said Mum Snap. "How can you help staring?" said Judy. "So gross." "Oh yuck, it's moving," Rochelle squealed. Mum cradled her tummy and the bulgy bit wiggling uncomfortable. "I hope it won't wiggle navel. I hope it won't wiggle too much." Mum's navel looked ready to pop out like a pork. "I used to think that's how babies were born. that was weird enough. I don't mention things. Last thing. I'm actually just going to end this video now because I don't think I've been really out of breath. So, and I don't know if you've heard it, but if you watch PewDiePie, he has two pets that look exactly the same as these two.